So in this video, I'm going to go through with you how to create the various heat effects that you will find in Hollow Knight. And to follow this video effectively, you will have to have taken a look at or watch this first particle effects introduction video, because we set up a couple of materials and a sprite sheet that we'll be using to create all of the effects in this tutorial. So let's get started. First effect you want to create is this effect. Heat effect. Alright, so there are a couple of components to this. There is a big slash and then there are some smaller slashes. Okay, this arc over here is not part of the special effect. This is just the slash animation, which is separate from the heat effect. Let's jump right into Unity and let's start creating a particle effect. So I'm gonna be using the URP system because we have a Metroidvania tutorial series, and in that tutorial series our project is currently using URP, but you can do this just fine following the built-in render pipeline system as well. What you want to do first is to let's go over the texture sheet animation and let's go to sprites. You can't do this if you're in HDRP, you have to use a different material. So first thing I'm gonna do is to change the sprite over here. Second thing I want to do is, if you look at the sprites that we have over here, right, the edges are a little dull. So what I'm going to do is go to renderer and set the material here to be additive. What this does is this brightens up the lines, which now looks more like a slash, right? Next thing I want to do is to disable shape so that everything appears in one line like this. And for emission over here, I'm just going to set the rate over time to 0. And then the burst here will be 1. I'm gonna set the speed to 0 as well so that the particle just stays in one place. And I'm gonna go to the start size over here and set the start size to 3D. And then the start size here is gonna be like 3 to 4 so that we get a large slash. You can also randomize the X a little bit so that the slashes, if you click on reset over here, you will see different slashes every time you spawn the particle effect. So if you want some variance, you can just randomize the values in ways that you prefer. I'm also gonna just play around with the rotation over here to get the values that I want. So I'm just gonna set the rotation here to 75 and maybe 85. And what this will do is give me slashes like that. So you will see every time this animation plays, the slash becomes slightly different. You also want to check whether when you set the scale to -1, does this effect still appear? This is very important. In your material, you got to make sure that the render phase is set to both if you're in URP. If you're in built-in render pipeline, then you have to make sure that you have the two-sided option checked. So refer to watch this first particle effect introduction to understand what I'm talking about. So we have this main line over here, and this is like half of it done. The particle effect is running, but I have to turn off looping, set duration to 1. And then set the lifetime to be a very small value, let's say 0.1, 0.15. And you may also want to create a little color of a lifetime like this and just set the color to be from 0 to max. So then you see the slash appears like that. Looks a little bit nicer, right? Because it looks like it's growing over time, see that? I'm just gonna call it slash. So now that we've done this, we have like half of our effect. Okay, so then the other thing that we want to do is to head over to stop action and set destroy. What this does is that when you spawn this effect in the game, this effect will play once and destroy itself. This is very important because otherwise when the particle effect finishes playing, the game object will still be there. Okay, so once this is done, we're gonna head over to slash and then let's just go over and create another particle effect here. And this one will be the smaller slashes. Okay, this one is gonna be a lot of fun to do as well. So I'm just gonna call this the splash. So particle effects, usually they are made of multiple particle systems, not just one. I'm just gonna set the duration to 1, looping to 0. And same thing, I'm just gonna go to renderer and set the material to additive. Go to texture sheet animation and assign the same sprite to it as well. This line here. And you start to see these lines appear. And I'm gonna go to emission and set the rate over time to 0 and just do a burst. Okay, burst of 8. And we're gonna set the speed over here to 0. And the lifetime can be 0.1 to 0.15, right? So these things will appear only for a while. Let's go to shape next, and then let's change this to sphere, not hemisphere. And we will have these lines like that. And then we want to scrunch all the lines together so they're all very compact. And then you want to start rotation, randomize between two constants. And over here, I'm going to set the rotation from 0 to 180, and then you'll get it's very nice effect over here. Okay, if you feel like it's too bright, you can always reduce the number of slashes. Yeah, so this might make it better. And in the sphere, you can also change the way that the slashes are spread out. So if you do a ping pong, right, for example, you will see that the stashes are more inclined to all face the same direction, whereas if you do, say, a loop, using different settings. Okay, so you can play around with this and you can see which one you prefer. When you work with particle systems, a lot of times, just tweaking little values to see what result you will get can be pretty fun. So one thing that I like to do as well for all my effects, right, is that I like to always assign two modules over here. One is color over lifetime. So I want the, again, I want the stashes to kind of fade into existence. So I want the stashes to go from transparent to opaque. And then after that, I also want to do a size over lifetime and just make them shrink away. Okay, maybe it's not a good idea. Let me just grab the inspector out. Okay, so size over lifetime, when you select it, you will see some graphs over here. This basically means that the particle effect grows from zero out to maximum size. And then this is the reverse, where the particle effect shrinks inwards. So of course, shrinking inwards doesn't look very good. So you want the slashes to grow outwards. And there you have it. This is the first effect. This is not a one-to-one because I suspect that in certain parts of Hollow Knight, they use sprites to animate parts of their particle effect. So I can't do a one-to-one for you, but this is the most similar I can do given the Kenny spreadsheet. So there are a variety of slash effects in Hollow Knight, and this main one, this big one is one of them. So the other effect that you will see in Hollow Knight, right, is this. If you hit something that cannot be damaged, you will also see this small little effect over here. It's pretty similar to the one that we had. Second effect is just the same thing, but minus the slash. So it's just a splash like that. Okay, so you probably, if you're creating a game and you want to have different feedback for different kinds of hits, then you may want to pull out the splash over here and make it a separate prefab. And then you want to make the slash a prefab by itself. So then you have one effect that's like this, and then one effect that's like this. So the other kind of effect that you find in Hollow Knight as well is that you will find if you hit 4 hits in the game, you will get a different kind of slash. Okay, you'll get 2 slashes that are in more or less the same direction. Like this. And this is pretty similar to the slash effect that we're creating as well. Actually, we can just use the existing slash effect, right? So let's say this slash is for environment. Okay, so here we just have to do a couple of modifications to our slash. So here I'm gonna remove the splash, and for the slash environment, the angle is always 90 degrees, right? So let me just set this angle to constant 90 degrees. And then because we have 2 lines, I'm also going to get the emission over here and go to burst and then set this to 2. This time I'm gonna have to have a shape for my slash, and this shape here is going to box. See that? So if I have a box over here, you will see the 2 slashes appear in different places all the time. The other thing that you will find in the slash is that if you look at the footage again, you will find there is some smoke that comes out. Okay, so this smoke here, I'm just gonna do a simple one. For this smoke, I'm gonna be using, again, a burst, and say a burst of 16 with shape of sphere. Now let's go over to the texture sheet animation and just find an appropriate smoke texture. So under texture sheet animation, I'm able to assign multiple sprites. And because if you look at the sprite sheet that we have a couple of smoke textures and they can be animated. So I'm just gonna put 3 of these frames inside. You can pick 3 of your favorite frames so that your smoke kind of has an animation. So let's set a timer with the lifetime. Anyway, the smoke won't exist for a very long time. Right now, the smoke looks very mediocre, right? So let's go back to the shape and reduce the radius so that we can see the smoke coming from a smaller area. And next, for smoke, let's do a burst spread so that the smoke always spreads evenly across as far as possible anyway. And then most important thing, right, is we want to make the smoke look organic. So I'm just gonna randomize the rotation first, 0 to 180. And then we are also going to set the speed to be random. So let's say 8 to 10. Now the smoke already is flying very far, and then we will randomize the size to be 1 to 4. So then we have different sizes of smoke, right? Most important thing, we want to reduce the lifetime to say 0.5 and 1. Then you see the smoke will last for a shorter amount of time. See, the smoke is traveling really far, which maybe it's not a good thing. I'm just gonna reduce the size as well. It's way too big. Okay, next thing I want to do is to go over to limit velocity over lifetime, and I'm gonna set the speed to dampen if it's greater than, say, 4. Dampen will be 1. So then this will cause the smoke, see that? To slow down over time. I'm just gonna reduce the lifetime of the smoke because I think it's way too long. Okay, now we're almost there. What I like to do always with smoke is to do a size over lifetime, but it's reversed. Let me just pull this out again so you can see that the size over lifetime graph is going to be big to small, so that you see the smoke kind of dissipates away, which is very important, right? And then let's do a color lifetime as well, and let's make the smoke also lose transparency over time, so then you get this very nice smoke effect over here. And lastly, we also want to go to renderer and then make sure that the material, right, is subtractive, because you want the smoke to be dark. Doesn't work if the smoke is bright, right? Like this. And then we can go to the color for the smoke, start color here, and then just reduce the alpha. Maybe let's just set it to gray so that it's not so obvious, because in the Hollow Knight, if you look at the stashes, the smoke really isn't very obvious. Okay, I'll leave you to adjust the color on your own, right? But you can see the smoke here kind of working, right? And the last effect I want to go through is this. If you hit the door, you'll see this effect. Okay, this is a little harder to do. So this shockwave effect is that. So note that the attack animation, the arc of the attack, see that, is blended in with the shockwave. So I'm gonna show you how you can do the shockwave, and this will be quite different from how we've done everything else so far. Okay, so for the shockwave, right, we will want to create another particle effect. And this time we will retain the shape over here. So the shape over here is a cone, which is great. We're gonna increase the angle of the cone, and we're gonna decrease the radius. So you will see the splash will come out all from a very small area. Again, we want everything to come out as a burst like that. So the rate over time should be 0. And to make our lives easier, right, we're just gonna change this whole thing into a trail. So then you see this thing will leave a trail. Okay, trails are a little tricky. Over here, I'm just gonna set the trail to have a wave that goes like this, so it's sharp at the start and sharp at the end. Random between two curves would be better, because then you'll get the thing looking a lot more organic. Okay. So what I have here is wave over trail, random between two curves. Just playing around with the shape over here so that I get different lines each time. And I'm going to also disable inherent particle color and size effects width, so that I can just go to the particle start color here and turn off the alpha. So what this does is that I just get a bunch of trails like that. And then next thing I need to do is just to reduce the lifetime of my trails. 0.3. So then I'll get a very small splash. See that? Almost there-ish. Okay, so if you want to make the edges sharper, you can just play around with the curves over here. And you can of course also reduce the burst. Get different sizes. Just gotta play around with the values over here. This should be additive, right? It shouldn't be sprightly default. So let me just find the additive particle. Additive. And the trail material should be additive as well. And this will give me something like this. So we already have the splashing. And then if you feel like it doesn't fill up enough, one thing that we can do is we can play around also with the trail. We have lifetime, right? So we want to have some trails leave a very long tail and then some trails leave a very short tail. So for example, lifetime can be 0.6 to 0.9. So let me show you what lifetime does, right? Lifetime basically means that it makes some of the trails very short. See that over here we have a trail that's very short because the lifetime over here is randomized from 0.1 to 0.9. 0.1 means the trail is 10% of the length that the particle travels. So you see this, some of these trails are very short because the lifetime is set to a very low value. So I'm just gonna set the lifetime to be 0.7 to 0.9. We have to play around with the shape a little bit, the radius, give you a larger base, probably is a good idea. And the other thing I wanna do also is to increase the speed a lot. So I'm just gonna randomize the speed 7 to 10. So then you'll see the lines become a lot more exciting to look at, right? Because it's just more active. And I'm going to go to limit velocity of lifetime, and over here I will dampen the velocity by 70% when the maximum speed is say above 8, maybe like above 5. I can also add some drag. Sorry, I need dampening of 0.5 maybe. So you can set very high speeds and then just try and dampen the speeds. or use drag to slow down the particles so that they don't go that far. So they feel like a burst, right? Because the starting speed is very high. But then after that, you know, they slow down after a while. So you gotta play around with this. This is not a one-to-one because we have to find the right... You have to create a custom material for it. So that because not right now, the additive particle that we have, right, is circular. So then you see the lines are not straight. Yeah, so the drawback of using the default material is that the lines are straight. But then, you know, it doesn't blend very well. So you can play around with materials as well and see if you can find a suitable material that can give you the correct splashing effect. Let me just put the additive material back here. Can I get the lines to be thicker at the base? There we go. So I've gone back to the wave over trail and just increased the size of the line over here so that it looks fatter at the start. And then you can perhaps reduce the lifetime to say 0.3, 0.9, so you have some lines that are very short. So once you get the right effect that you want, I'm just gonna play around with reducing the start color as well. Sorry, it's the wrong thing. The color should be edited at the color over on top, should be alpha. At the bottom here, under trails, color of lifetime, let me set the color of lifetime to gradient and just make the trail kind of fade away after a while. Yeah, so this looks much better, right? So little things like that you gotta play around with to get the trail to have the pattern that you want. So once it's done, right, what you want to do next is to make sure that you rotate the particle effect right. So you want to rotate this in the Y direction so that you get this. And then when you scale the effect, let me scale this one. It's not the Y direction. So you gotta see which direction you want to scale the effect as well, with the Z direction. Yeah, so depending on where you scale and where you rotate the effect, you will get the effect facing different places. So the cool thing about the effects that we've just done as well, right, is that these effects don't only work in 2D, even though we've created it for Hollow Knight, because it works in 3D as well. Okay, so if you have a 3D game and you have a hit effect, you can also... Same thing, alright? And the slash effect as well, it works in 3D. See that? Whether it's 2D or 3D, it works regardless. Maybe the smoke's a little too black, so I'll leave you to adjust the opacity of the smoke. That's all I have. I hope this video has been useful. Thank you.